great to be with you guys this morning. It's a beautiful day outside, and we're here to talk about grief, loss, and trauma. And I'm sorry to do that to you, but I promise I will make it as positive as I possibly can. So in life, each of us will experience loss. We have always turned to our philosophers to understand this concept. One of these philosophers, Kermit the Frog, said, life is made up of meetings and partings. That is the way of it. Here, Kermit teaches us that though we wish it were neither, loss is both universal and inevitable. Some losses are recognized generally as significant and capable of producing grief. Some of those losses are the death of a friend, the diagnosis of a disability, or the end of a relationship. Other losses are not well recognized, things like moving or a crisis of faith. The truth is, no matter what the crisis, no matter what the loss, it is potential for grief. Grief is the emotional expression of a loss. And though grief is often expressed in terms of stages, it is not simply progressing from denial to acceptance. It's often much more messy and much more complicated. Some losses can produce great grief, and people who experience this type of grief may need extra support from friends, family, their church organization, or even a mental health authority. Another aspect of this existence is trauma. Though not all of us will experience post-traumatic stress disorder, we will all likely experience at least one potentially traumatic event. Some of those events can produce post-traumatic stress in others, and in others it may not. What makes the difference is not the experience itself, but some other factors, like what has the person experienced before this particular trauma? What does the trauma mean to them? And what are their coping skills? We'll talk more about that as we move forward. But the important thing to know about trauma is, like loss and like grief, most of us will experience some amount of trauma in our lives. So what does that mean? Grief is described by Sheryl Sandberg as hitting us like a wave and rolling back like the tide, which means initially when we feel grief, it hits us with a lot of power, and then slowly those feelings reside. As they reside, we find ourselves either coming back to where we were, recovery, or growing beyond that. Growing beyond our grief and growing beyond trauma is something that has been shown time and time again in different science experiments and with different people. And we have a group at Kids on the Move dedicated to helping people grow past traumas and other experiences. Ernest Hemingway described trauma this way: the world breaks everyone, and after, some are strong in the broken places. Our group is designed to help people grow in their broken places and become stronger. How do we become stronger? There are lots of different things that people can do to cope with grief and loss and trauma. One of the things that we often describe in our group, one of the things that we prescribe, is that people use short-term distractions, things like watch a little TV, have a good conversation with somebody, maybe go watch a movie, play a video game. Those are short-term solutions. Some longer-term solutions are have a real, authentic relationship with someone, someone that you can trust, someone that you can explain things to, and really describe your thoughts and your feelings. Another really important aspect is to allow yourself the freedom to continue to grow and to continue to express yourself without judgment. If you need to cry, cry without attaching any judgment that this is good or bad. If you need to laugh, laugh without saying, I shouldn't be laughing right now, I should be sad. Another thing that we often talk about is expressive communication. So expressive writing, dance, other ways that you can express your emotions without any judgment at all. As you use these things, we find that people are able to better cope with and express their thoughts and their feelings. One more thing that I think is missing, and it's an essential element in all of our lives, is the element of listening. M. Scott Peck described listening as the most important form of communication that we can give our loved ones. And then further went on to say, true listening is love in action. As we listen to one another, we can understand one another and we can grow. Without listening to each other, we become separated and we become islands. And we can really truly believe that loss and grief and trauma are isolated events and we're the only ones that feel them. But the truth is, because grief, loss, and trauma are all universal and our responses to these things are so human, we can understand other people and indeed be understood. Thank you.